Oilers will be in Vancouver on Monday, and we'll have that game for you. Bob Klinkhammer. Boxes alive, centering pass, and Chris Golub got a piece of it. Out in front, it comes again, and Chris Golub stopped the anvil. 19th time they've been involved in a one-goal game. Mail Yakupov on the ice right now with Mark Arcabello and Jesse Joensuu. Arcabello shot, Smith the save. Joensuu looking for the rebound.
Tracking down pucks, Kevin, getting it back to the blue lines, and a couple real decent shots with Vic Joensuu in front being the screen.
Vadim Verbata gets hammered to the ice by Ryan Jones. Shots even at three apiece. Lori Korpakoski just inside the line. Korpakoski waits for a crowd, then lets it go. A rebound in front for Butker, but he was taken nicely there by Sam Gagne.
And at the absolute most inopportune time, the stick blows up.
Klinkhammer drops it to Yandel. Long shot on Brizgalov. He'll handle it.
And Verbata, it's been a little bit of a stretch for him offensively, especially scoring goals, trying to get back into the scoring ways.
Mike Smith makes a stop. Hendricks gets it back to Gordon. He lets another shot go. There's a chance for Jones. Another chance. Ferentz and Potter, along with Arcabello and Smith, as Shane Doan goes cross ice. Antoine Vermette drops it back. Vermette to the point to Yandel. Yandel will give it to Butker. Mikhail Butker to Ekman Larson with a wrist shot through traffic. Brizgalov makes the save, and he'll hang on. So Ekman Larson and Yandel, when these teams were here, that did a lot of damage in that 6-2 game. Yandel with the puck now. Yandel goes down low, right out in front. Butker shot, did not get all of it. Butker saved by Brizgalov. For the Coyotes so far, 15 seconds left to go in the power play. An opportunity for Vada from a sharp angle. Brizgalov slid over and made the save.
Yeah, it's going to be a grind, no question about it. This is the time for Dave Tippett and the Phoenix Coyotes. They cannot allow too much of a separation to happen right now in the standings.
Smith juggled it, and coming to get it was Chipchura. Alice Akins told us that Yakupov would be on the fourth line, but would get power play time, and he's got it right now. He's got the puck, centering pass for Joensuu. Stopped by Smith. Drafted free agent. There's a long shot by Stone. Steered aside by Brizgalov. 11 shots for the Coyotes, 10 for the Oilers.
Have to go back and turn and find it. So little chips into the corner on the forecheck will work effectively in that regard.
Bodker's shot finds the net. Mikhail Bodker, his 15th goal of the season, and his first in his last 8 games, opens the scoring here. It's 1-0 Phoenix.
And we saw a long stretch pass by Edmonton right before this. And here, Bodker, a little broken play on the blue line. This is 3-4 Edmonton Oilers around this puck. Watch, bang. On the tape in the middle, eventually it finds its way wide to Bodker, who just takes the puck to the net, gets inside the dot, and rips it through far side over the shoulder of Brizgalov. A real nice shot. Good stick flex on this one here as he just zings it, Mark Messier style.
Into the corner for Petrie, intercepted by Hanzel. Back to Verbata. At the point is Yandel. Yandel to Verbata. Verbata with a wrist shot through traffic, deflected wide. Hanzel behind the net to Ribeiro in the corner. Mike Ribeiro gets it to Hanzel right out in front. Verbata scores. Hanzel and Verbata click on the power play. It's 2-0. And you can see the chemistry between 11 and 17.
Nice little spin-around, a back pass by Mike Ribeiro, too. I think it was, you know, unfortunately a bad call on Hendricks for the double minor, but you have to kill it off. And good work down low by Hanzel, gets it through. And watch Ribeiro here as he just kind of works his way up. No looker behind the back, right to Hanzel, one-timer onto the tape of Verbata, and he zings it home. And as you mentioned before the game, Verbata has struggled as of late to score goals, only 2 in his last 23. And big celebration for him after. You can tell there's a big weight lifted off of his shoulders there as he gives his team a 2-0 lead.
14 shots for the Coyotes, 11 for the Oilers. Klinkhammer to Halpert. Halpert throws it out in front for Moss. Stepping into a shot and scoring is the Albertan Derek Morris. The Edmonton kid makes it 3-0.
He can crush the puck too, and this one just pops right out to him here. A little bit of a disconnect between the defense and forwards of Edmonton. Backtracking into the zone, you can see the shiner there. Derek Morris is still sporting, and he's always had that big blast from the blue line. And as you watch, a little bit too far backing in allows Phoenix to have a possession entry. Good play by Halpert to try and chuck it out to the middle, and as a result it goes right through to Derek Morris following up. And because this gets through, Nugent Hopkins tries to block this one. But this one had eyes through everybody. He just beats the glove.
Got cut in an optional practice in his 16th year.
insult to injury.
Hall back to the point. Petrie waiting for it there, throws it towards the net. Opportunity for Hall. He was knocked down and a penalty coming. Drops back for Nugent Hopkins. Goes cross ice for Hall. Hall waits, delays to Schultz. He goes back again to Taylor Hall. Hall moving in. Nugent Hopkins with it now. Ryan Smith is in front. This is Schultz. Down low for Eberle. Eberle back to Schultz. Over to Hall. One-time blast and a pad save by Mike Smith. Ribeiro goes to an open wing and is picked up there by David Moss. Moss chips it by Marincin. Petrie against Doan. Petrie goes down. Moss has the puck. Moss has got Ribeiro in it in front and he tips it home. Moss threw it to the front of the net and Mike Ribeiro took that one out of the air to make it a 4-0 game.
And just another puck battle lost down low. It's Jeff Petrie to get to this puck first, but he loses a wheel as he goes in. So just trying to protect, goes down, and it's 2-on-1 as David Moss is there, picks up the puck relatively easily. And nice hand eye here by Mike Ribeiro as he just flies into the zone. This is a waist-high wrister pass, or maybe not quite that high. It actually went off the blocker, Brizgov. Didn't realize it. Off the blocker first, up off the stick body of Ribeiro, and right off the stick. So good.
Arcabello. Yakubov to Arcabello. Throws it towards the net. Tipped by Petrie. And Smith makes the save. Klinkhammer. Klinkhammer. Herbata and Chipchura. Chipchura behind the net. Chipchura plays it back to the point. McCulloch snaps one. Tipped by Verbata right on to Brizgalov. And he'll hang on as Verbata looks for the rebound. There isn't one. That 2009-2010 season, they are 7-2-1. Combined record against Vancouver, Calgary, and Edmonton. Anton Belak throws it towards the net. Smith to save. And he'll hang on. Hanzel and Gordon line up. Gordon gets down low. They both go down. It is Jones out in front. It's tipped in by Matt Henricks. His first goal in an Oiler uniform. And it's 4-1. His third goal of the year, but his first point for the Oilers.
A little signal afterwards to see if this one went off the skate of Hendricks, but nice play off the faceoff as Gordon battles Hanzel, and then it's Ryan Jones who just throws it into the blue paint. Matt Hendricks drives to the net, and Ray here, it does ricochet off the skate of Hendricks up over top of Mike Smith. This one's going to count as it was not a kicking motion, a redirection.
His first goal in 21 games as the Oilers on the board. Chipchura shot steered aside by Brizgalov. Big Martin Hanzel, 6'6", 230 pounds. Tipped by Verbata off the crossbar. Another shot off the bar, this time by Tim Kennedy. Keeps it in on the far side. Eberle behind the net. Stone takes him into the boards. Eberle shrugs him off and then Stone runs into Hall, but here's Eberle with a shot. Smith got a piece of it. Nugent Hopkins tries to get it in from a sharp angle. The Oilers have to do here to work their way back into this game.
What they're doing, they're getting pucks in deep and trying to find shots from every area.
David Perron goes upstairs and scores. They listen, and Perron takes over the team lead. He's got 19 goals on the year.
And what a move by Perron. You know, and Kevin, it comes down to just wanting it a little bit more. This third period has to be all about getting pucks in deep, all about establishing the shot, having bodies in front, and just battling to get your opportunities. I like the poise by Marincin earlier in this shift on the blue line. He held his ground, kept the pressure on. Perron, a fresh body on the ice, goes out, picks up the puck, and just a dump in wide by Potter off the boards. Aggressive forecheck, puck turns over as Ribeiro can't handle it. And does David Perron ever go upstairs? Top shelf here on the backhand side, up over top of the shoulder of Mike Smith.
Nugent Hopkins. Gordon to Hall. Hall back up top for Justin Schultz. He'll get it back again. Nugent Hopkins cross ice. Here's Eberle moving in. His shot is stopped by Smith. Gordon looking for the rebound. Mike Smith stops it. Gave it away to Yakubov. And he put it in front. Smith got the stick there. Verbata sent it the length of the ice.
Little rush.
Hanzel. Trying to make a move around Hall. He brings down Hall. Play continues. Corey Potter in there, along with Eberle. Eberle dancing in. Nugent Hopkins shot. He scores. Jordan Eberle with a beautiful setup. Finished off by Ryan Nugent Hopkins. It's 4-3.
Well, no question, Kevin, the Oilers playing with a little more fire here in this third period. Good backtrack right here by Taylor Hall. Loses his footing, but stays in the battle. Nice pass by Hopkins. The looker by Everly. And I'll tell you what, talk about dusting the puck off a few times here. Everybody kind of has a little handle on it. And through all those skates, eventually it's Nugent Hopkins. They just zips it through. Not a hard shot, but an accurate one. Beats
middle pass to Gagne. Gagne knocked down by Halpern. Doan brings it in. Doan lets that shot go. Glove save by Drysgalov, and he'll hang on.
That's a play down low by Justin Schultz, not to try and go one way or the other on Mike Ribeiro. Mike Ribeiro is a real shifty customer on the ice.
Make him a pass. Oh, the giveaway, the shot! And Mike Smith the save, and he'll cover up.
Wow.
Ekman Larson, long shot. Drysgalov makes the save. Potter's got it. Corey Potter off the referee. Stepping into the shot is Halpern, but there is Drysgalov to make the save. And get the whistle.
For Hall, who's really stepped it up a notch in this third.
Ryan Smith won the draw, but Antoine Vermette stole the pass from Potter. He lets the shot go over his goal off the save. Potter centers it.
That was a good pass right there by Derek Morris. Under pressure, under siege by two guys. Just a little spin backhand on the tape out of the zone.
Rizgalov hangs onto the shot from Yandel. Sit around the boards. Everly starts away. Dumps it in. A bouncing puck controlled by Smith, but that will do it. And the Oilers, Taylor Hall, still wants an explanation as to why there was no icing. But the final score leads Coyotes 4, the Oilers 3.